What is up, YouTube, and you gorgeous subscribers of mine and viewers? Thank you all for watching my Coliseum content. I know there's tons of other Coliseums you guys can watch. So for the ones do I viewers that I do have, thank you for watching my Coliseum series. I like to give you every room, every single strategy, just the complete thing. For this one, I wish I could have gave it to you guys, but it's over like 5 hours of me strategizing and coming close with so much teams and just missing like my one orb or me missing my perfects and stuff. I couldn't fit all of that into a video that you guys can actually watch. So we are gonna do the Choas Kid Coliseum right here. You can see things say clear because I cleared everything and then my video got corrupted for the first half of my video. So we're just gonna fix it over and hope you guys enjoy. This video that you guys are watching is gonna be the complete guide. It's just I had to redo like a certain part in it. The team we're gonna use to clear this first part is a double Fuji team. If you don't have access, which a lot of people probably won't, to a double Fuji team, or a lot of people might actually have access to it. It's okay. You can use a double. You can use a double Dofi and a full slasher team. You can use a double Dex Mihawk. All you have to do is make sure you bring Coliseum Hina, who's a free-to-play unit, because you can get it from the Coliseum, and use her special. It'll take down Ace's shield. For you guys that are wondering, Ace's shield, we'll get into the video real quick to show you guys. The only unit I'm missing for a double Fuji team to make this absolutely just incredible is a Caesar. If I had Caesar, I could definitely replace either Usopp or Zoro. We're bringing Usopp because Usopp helps us stall though, so we would definitely replace Zoro with Caesar. We barely had matching orbs that run there, but we have matching orbs now, so we're gonna lock you while we heal up. Oh, yeah, we'll just kill you. We're gonna have to get two of our characters locked, but it's okay. We gotta stall for turns anyway. Three turns, and you stall for two turns on a random one random unit. He took out our Fuji. Okay, so we're gonna take out you. Let's go ahead and take out you. He's gonna lock our Dex units for two turns, but we have, well, three turns, but we have the anti-lock level one, and we can't kill any of them this turn, so we're stuck taking attacks. It's cool though. It gives us time to stall and heal up a little bit. On to the next room. Two units we gotta kill. Let's take out these units, bruhs. Oop. Oop. Ooh, gotta be so careful though. Okay. I want to have Usopp ready by the next room because you can't use Usopp on Ace himself, guys. So we're not planning on doing that. But you at least want to use Usopp twice this raid. I mean, this Coliseum. Want to use him at least twice. Let's kill off as much of these units as we can. Preferably we only want to leave one alive. So we can do this. Take that attack. You're gonna use Usopp here. We get four turns of stall, but we're gonna be looking for orbs while we stall. Let that 500 auto heal also kick in. Not too bad of a heal. This is actually giving me. Oh, quick shout out. I really appreciate all the help you guys do on my channel just from your views and subscribes alone. We're at 56. The goal is to have 100 by come around next time summer. So hopefully I know we can get there, guys. If you guys just keep liking, commenting on the channel, you guys are really making me happy that I started this little hobby of mine. He turns this into something I actually really enjoy doing. So I really want to say thank you to those who watch my videos and to those who are subscribed. An even bigger thank you. Okay. Five turns compared to seven turns. Not that bad, actually. We can actually store that. Now, you won't be able to take use of your Fuji Toro's special in this Coliseum. But one thing you can do, and you won't be able to stall them, so Usopp is useless too. That's what I said, bring you a Caesar there instead, or bring you if we brought Coliseum Hina, we could have broke Ace's barrier and then use two Fuji Toros in one turn. And that could have been a way that we got to hit him without Fuji Toros. And then from there we just have to break his guard every single turn after. But you can still take great advantage of your Fuji Toros, you just won't get that start off hit. And I'm gonna show you guys exactly how you do that. So you can't use Usopp at all. So he's completely pointless in this raid now. Do do do. But I'm gonna show you guys how to take advantage of Fuji Toro. And I'm going to do that right now. So you can use Usopp to stall, and this first hit won't cut his HP. But let me show you guys what it can do. Do, 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 do. We got no damage reduced. Oh, we do. Perfect. Okay. See, that did completely nothing. But after breaking his guard, this is why Fuji Toro is literally such a good unit. Kaboom. It cuts his HP at the end of the turn, too. So it's good. Luckily, it's not like every start of the new turn you get to cut his HP, because then you'll be missing out on a crap ton of damage. We're gonna try to heal up as much as possible. Ace didn't activate the buff, so we're still good this turn. This is our final turn of our first Fuji Toro. Second Fuji Toro should kick in. There's already guides up, and I would have had at least my guide for this video up already, but thanks to corruptions and videos from stuff I don't know. Okay. And Smoker makes a good driven unit because he gets to cut HP by 50% for 3 turns. So we're gonna use him when Ace is on a 1 turn cooldown. That way we get to technically tank 2 of Ace's attacks. And the attack that we want to tank is the special that he does, which is coming up right now. So Fuji Toro is going to activate at this turn. I suggest using this turn right now to do your big burst because we're going to push him into 20% anyway, and he has that auto heal. You don't want that to activate. See, that's why Zoro makes such a good unit. If he has that one matching orb you need, even though you don't want him to have a negative orb, his specials that like do an effect, but also is like orb manipulation, are just so gorgeous. They render me speechless. Yeah, slashes get an attack buff. Boom, and Ace is gone. We didn't even get to touch Dofi, who would have had the highest attack. Because he would have got a 1.75 type boost. He would have got the 3x3 times 1.5 attack boost from the captains in the ship. He would have got his own attack because he has 1,000. He has 15,009 attack. He would also got the dex type, the attribute type buff, and the 2x orb boost. So that's Ace Guys, pretty easy for a double Fuji team. Next is Domino. Ho-ho-ho-ho-ho. You can also use a Fuji Toro team against her. We're going to be using a double Rayleigh. What up, double Ray? Ooh, good, 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 good. Our double Ray team. Here we are. Whenever you see Domino, you can always think locks. Locking, locking, locking. You see Saidy Chan, you see buffs such as attack buffs, defense buffs, or enragement. Domino is known for locking. So what we're going to do in these early turns is we're going to just choose one enemy, which is the cannon in the middle, and we're going to severely just stall on him. Look at Usopp. Look at Usopp with the knockouts. The units here are pretty low in HP. How much you hit us for? Wow, that's a lot of damage, isn't it? But we get to heal up. And I'm not going to stop any of these attacks because we don't want to be here forever. But we do want to get a good enough stall. Ooh, that was a miss too, so he would have been dead either way. Next room, take a Cyclops to third fight against the Cat Burglar. I don't know what he's talking about. I think he's asking us to kill him, which we could oblige. Boom. Cat Burglar Nami? Huh? Is that what he's making a reference to? We're gonna let this quick unit hit this guy here. He should lock us, so we're going to just stall out, let him get off his lock. His frustration that he let the Straw Hats get away. Go ahead and lock my Dofi for 3 turns, but we have level 2 anti-lock. Gonna take an attack here. And we can heal up from it. We're gonna use Usopp here, and then from here on in, after we stall these turns, it's just gonna be us killing, having fun. Oh no, I didn't mean to do that. I want to keep that. And now you die. Come, come. Hello, room with a bunch of strong soldiers. Beware, most of these guys can come like level one. I mean, 1 turn cooldown. Legit. Like, my first time clearing this, I think they were all level one, except for probably one. I'm not sure. Okay, 5 more turns to Domino. But again, we're gonna get those 5 turns off so easy. There's no need for us to, like, sit here and stall perfectly. Which we need more than 5 turns, actually. We actually need 6 turns, but. Who's counting? Certainly not I. Ooh. Knockout slash. 4 more turns until we can use and talk. 3 more turns. Two more turns. 1 more turn. She'll bide one of your random units for 99 turns. No! Tofei! She always seems to do that. We're gonna go ahead and use Usopp. Go ahead and use Ray Ray. Do your thing, Ray Ray. Do your thing, Ray. Do your thing, Ray Ray. Do your thing, Ray. Go ahead and use the other Ray Ray. Do your thing, Ray. Do your thing, Ray Ray. We're gonna also use Ooh, Luffy. Sama! And now we're going to just sit back and watch as we do extraordinary damage. Even though we don't have the 2x orb boost. Under 50%, she will lock another unit for 99 turns, but only when she attacks. So as long as she's delayed, you guys don't have to worry about it, basically. On her second turn, she should lock a unit for 2 turns. But we have level 2 anti-lock, so that lock is gone. And that's Domino, guys. Pretty quick and easy, right? Just bring a dex team that can burst, bring a turn delayer, and you can legit just do this. Because she won't do any locking, any 99 turn locking, unless she attacks. So as long as she's delayed, that's one of the easiest rooms, like. Next is Talnami, which we will be doing, guys. We're gonna use a double NL team. I hope you guys enjoyed the video. I'm gonna kind of cut it off in the middle because it's way too long of the method I had to use to beat her. A team that I'm gonna try off stream, and if it works, I'll show you guys the video, is a Log Luffy team. Another team I'm thinking about using is a double Sabo team, guys. A double Sabo, bring the fighter of Free Spirit Ivankov, which is the Ent Ivankov, because it removes the poison, heals you for 2 turns, and damage reduces. I brought a Boa, because she delays for a turn, and she heals you. I was bringing Log Luffy, but instead of a Log Luffy, Senior Pink works, in my opinion, a little bit better, because Senior Pink gives himself a Psy Orb, and he's Free Spirit with a good amount of attack, decent recovery, good HP. So, you know, he's not that worse of a sub than Log Luffy. Log Luffy is a way better captain, way better character. But Senior Pink gives you an orb boost, and he changes his own orb to Psy. So, Sabo gives you that 1.75, then that 2x boost. So, yeah. That team actually came really close. I just messed up my perfects. That's the only reason. But other than that, that team came super close. Like, literally, if I didn't miss that perfect, I would have had it. See, that team worked, but I'll see you guys for the Talnami video, and we're gonna complete this whole thing. After this video, it would be the video of the Sadie-chan Chaos Coliseum. I'm Igor Goma, and I'll see you guys in the next video. What's up, guys? Igor Goma here, part of True Grongers. You guys already know. Sorry for the delay on the Chaos Kid video. But guys, we're on round 3 now, and round 3 is going to be Happiness Punch Nami. She's going to have a crap ton of HP. She has 2.8 million HP, and she hits for 4,300, I believe, or 4,500 every turn, and she poisons you. So, bring somebody who can get rid of poison, and that's only a third of the battle. Because she's just such a hard Coliseum boss, because what she does is she'll have all damage she takes for 99 turns. What she'll also do is for the first 10 turns you can't even damage her unless you're a Psy unit. But remember, all damage is halved, so you'll have to do 4.6 million damage in one turn, and currently right now, I don't even think that's possible. So what we want to do is, you're going to want to stall, for all of the turns, until you get a Ivankov special.
Once you get Ivankov special, you can just pretty much move forward and do whatever you want. And there's two ways you can take out Nami. You can either stall her shield out completely with the NL team, which is just 100 hits, or you can get Nami down to about around 20%, and then burst her down from there. The only thing with that method is you have to make sure you can do enough damage. You know, since you're only doing half the damage you would normally do, you know, 20% of Nami's HP is less than a million, and it's less than five. Because she basically has around 3 million HP. So 20% of 2.8 million is about 500,000 at most. And to do 500,000 when your damage is halved, it's pretty hard. Especially with a non-type matchup. Definitely doable. But we only have Jabra's Orb Boost. So we're just stalling here for Eva-chan's special. And basically, what I recommend you do is, when you first go into the room, try it out. Try and see how well, you can actually damage. You can actually damage Nami. When I say go ahead and try it out, I just basically mean, use all your specials when you get to the room with Nami just to see how much exact damage you can actually do. Because if you can do more than 20% of HP, then you should be good to go. But with this team, you can't try it the moment you get into the room. Remember, she puts up that barrier. Let's move a little bit quick here, guys. Okay, and we're going to do this here. Again, this is just a more easier way to do it. Another way you can do this is, guys, it's pretty simple. You could use two Legend Sabos, a Senior Pink, a Ivankov, Boa, and a Golden Pound. And that team also works. Alex, if I have time when it comes back around, I'll try to show you guys what I'm talking about. So, first thing you want to do is negate that poison. Once you negate the poison, you want to look for matching orbs ASAP. You want to hold on to all of your recovery orbs. And there's a reason why, guys. She's gonna do this. And gloom your captain. So you won't be able to heal. Just for a couple of turns, though. So let's go ahead and still look for these recovery orbs. I brought Boa. There's tons of other quick units that might work well. Like, instead of bringing Jabra, if you have Legend Marco or Legend Dofi, that's a way better substitute than Jabra, because you get a better orb boost. I don't know how much Jabra boosts your orbs by. I should have probably brought Kaku, but hey, what's done is done. So again, you want to try and see how much damage you can normally do to her. Right after her 10 turn barrier is up, you're going to just do a semi test on how much damage you can do. And we're gonna do that this turn. Or any turn we get the chance to do it. Let's use Boa. Let's try to heal up and get these matching orbs. But we can't do it now because we just used Boa. So Nami would kill us if we tried to do it now. Gotta heal up first. We need to just survive for 8 turns, which is definitely possible because we only take 1,000 per, basically less than 1,000 per turn. We take 900 per turn. Human. So, again, just keep attacking. Pretty simple. We're just going to be stalling out. What we're doing now is we're looking for...
You want to leave when they come.
For...
There's a large white rice too, right?
We're looking for matching orbs so we can just test our burst. If we can't do more than 20% damage, we're going to just I'm gonna just fast forward the video for you guys, so that way you guys don't have to wait through this. Oh no, we needed that orb. We don't need any. Okay, we're good. We're good. We're back on track. Okay. Ooh, perfect. Perfect. Okay, so now we're gonna burst this turn. Just to see how much damage we can do. Let's see if doing 20% damage is possible with this team. Okay, let's back up Boa. And now we attack.
Yes? How about I put the answers for the ELA on the side and then you just rewrite them in the morning?
Okay. Oh.
Half an hour early and you just fill in the paper. Okay, that'll do that.
So, barely able to do damage, the 20% at least. So guys, I'm going to end the video here for one quick second so I can stall out the 71 turns. After the 71 turns, right before I kill her, I'll start the video again. So I'll see you guys in a little bit.
Okay guys, so we did all of the stalling and stuff. For you guys, it's probably gonna seem way quicker than it actually took. Stalling all turns for the shield to be gone. But the shield is almost gone, and we are about to get ready to set into the burst turns. Three more turns, the shield should be gone. And our characters are set up for us to have perfect matching orbs. Except for probably on Ivankov. But if we do get a one on Ivankov, wouldn't that just be magic? One more turn and then the shield is gone for good. So we are now ready to burst Nami. And even if Absalom and them come, we can take them out as well. The buff is gone. We have turn delayers and damage reducers, so. We're just going to be doing little bits of damage here and there to try to push Nami just a tad bit closer. And it's working. We're pushing her so close. Oh yeah. I think it's time we start playing around with her. Let's heal up. And we can finish this now, guys. Go ahead and activate out your Lucci. You only have to do this room once. It's not like she's the boss from anything, because then farming her would be impossible. Go ahead and activate Jabra. And then, oh no! 2,000 volts! And they do say activate the second anel, but we're going to save that anel. We're going to activate Eva. Ho. And then, ladies and gentlemen, We kill. So easy. 20% is so easy once you outlast the shield. And guys, if you have a hard time clearing that, that's exactly how you clear it. You don't even have to use that exact same team. And now it's free to play. You can bring you a Kung Fu Dugong to get rid of your poison. I don't think there's a quick card that I get to rid of poison. If there is, use them. You get a attack buff for them. And then you can just fill in some units. Now, round 4, guys. And your Slasher. We're going to use a double Fuji team for Khalifa to run fastest. So you guys can get to see the video. Okay. You'll do fine. Don't know what Khalifa does, nor do I care. We're going to obliterate her as long as she doesn't put up any barrier or anything like that. Keep it up. Okay. So, yep, she's the Dex Khalifa. So this Khalifa is the regular Khalifa. She just has a different animation. He's gonna lock our strength characters to do 4 or 3 turns. Also gonna lock our strength characters for 3 turns. And now we just have to... Our strength characters are gonna be locked for a long time. And we didn't get no matching orbs, that's the sad part. Oh jeez. 11 turn lock. Okay. So let's take out this guy. They don't hit for that much though. So let's see if we can take out. Oh no, we can't. Okay. So let's heal up. They don't hit for that much. Install here as long as we possibly can. If you have level 5 auto heal, you'll be good. Because he only hits for what? 1,500. Nope, he hits for... Oh, he attacks every 2 turns, though. We're supposed to be healing up, and we took so much damage. This is all the orbs for. They didn't give us no good orbs. But the next one, we're just gonna obliterate. Moving forward. In the second room, there's 2 girls that will despair you. You already know, take care of them. They can be highly annoying. There's 3 girls that would despair you, but only when they're attacked, they'll activate their despair. Boom. This is pretty simple. Still don't know what Khalifa does. So we have to keep that in mind. We can take the unit and back out last. She'll just keep healing them. Only a few more turns until Fuji and everybody can be activated. In this room, there'll be 3 girls who can despair you. There's actually 5, but 3 of them are on a 1-turn cooldown. I don't know if the cooldowns can change. Most likely it can.
nothing left but the turtle now. And who doesn't know how to stall on a turtle? 5 turns is what we need to stall for. When you enter the room with Khalifa, she'll preemptively do her special, which gives us negative matching orbs. She can't be delayed for 99 turns, so golden pounds are useless. Maybe Kid can be delayed. Who knows? We'll have to soon see. So go ahead and use your Fujitoros and get rid of all of these nasty orbs. We're going to have 2 matching orbs, but we're going to save our burst.
Ni-gi! Centauri! Yakari ni!
Bunch of Japanese words! We're going to use
Ovahito.
Activate another Fujitoro.
Splash.
Activate Faza. And we end it. And that is Khalifa. Stats pretty much for her round. Seriously, Nami is way harder than her. And guys, the final boss of these Coliseums is Coliseum Kid, which we are now hopping into. Eustace Kid. We get an HP or attack buff to him towards himself. We're just literally 1 level away from being able to hold Kuma on this team. Kuma or Shiki. But it's good. It's good. It's okay. We have to make sure we can do 25 hits. 5, 5, 5, 5, 5 is 20, 24, 28, okay. Yep, we can do enough damage. Just making sure we can break that barrier. Whew. Okay, guys, let's run through this one final time. Okay, guys, let's get right back in this Coliseum. I did not know what Kid does, and if I never took that special hit from Khalifa, I could have survived, literally. I would have been able to just tank it. Okay, let's break. We don't want anybody getting locked the first turn. We're going to let the unit, one of these units, just lock one of us. I prefer to let just the note get blocked. And Anti-lock brings it down to two turns. Anel has a meat orb that we so desperately want. We're going to ignore the first hit from the red giant. Everyone's attack is now times 20. Yada yada yudu. Okay. Let's kill him and move on. We're gonna let one of these units lock our now for two turns, because we still need to get off enough stall. Since we're not using Golden Pound, we gotta make sure we get off enough stall on all characters. No, I needed to get every single four hit. Moving into this room, Khalifa would say bring it on and shuffle our orbs to negative. We're going to just attack regularly to get rid of these negative orbs. And then we're going to proceed with cutting her HP down. Cut her HP. Okay, perfect. We pushed her close enough. Now we can end this quietly. No. Oh, I forgot. Ah, no. Okay. Here's to the point where we can't take any more unnecessary damage, so Khalifa has to go. Ooh, we gotta win this. Kid preempt, he puts on a delay block so he can't be delayed. He's gonna absorb 25 hit barrier. He blinks our orbs. Gonna right away just use smoker. Because we don't need that much turns to honestly kill him, guys, as we know. Fuji time.
We could burst here with a no, but that's very dangerous. We're gonna let Kid's HP drop a little bit more before we just decide to play it dangerous and burst him from this much HP. He's gonna give himself a massive defense up. Empty all our orbs. We only take half damage. There's still two more turns of Fuji. Boom. Thanks to this half damage. This is only gonna do half damage. Oh, yeah. And now, guys, this is where the end spells for Kid. This is I know you guys are gonna laugh when I say this, but this is actually a pretty easy fight. Okay, we need you need an orb. You need one. And you need one. Go ahead and use a no. And then go ahead and finish off the Coliseum. And that's Kid. And we got him to drop. So guys, I hope you guys enjoyed the video. This video is gonna be posted up. Probably with only like an hour left of the Kid Coliseum. Maybe even shorter because I have to really work on getting this video. It's a pretty fun thing. I would farm Kid. He's honestly not that hard. Ooh, look at him. Look at the badass. He is a driven striker, so he works for. He works well with Akuma. I know that much. And we got our five forbidden tomes, which I don't know who to feed them to. I'm Igor Gomuk, and I'll see you guys in the next chaos, which is going to be Sadie. Or we might do her when she comes back out because I don't have 110 stamina unless we can get a transponder now.
and then hurry it along. So I'll see you guys in the next video.